the same test, I don't remember what the percentage was, but it was considerably lower than what it is now. So they're working on him.
Yeah.
They're working on him. And I know eventually you'll be able to talk to Siri like that, but right now you can't. And that's, I would use my Alexa. I'm sorry, I said Siri. My Alexa. I would use Alexa more, but it's just so many commands or skills that you have to remember. And I've tried getting Alexa's help with the skills, and that don't even work. Alexa, is there a skill for, or Alexa, what skills do I have enabled? And she can't tell me. And I'm like, you should at least be able to tell me the skills, and that way I can hear the one that I need for, and then figure out the command. And
yeah, go from there.
Yeah.
So. Yeah. But I think that Google probably has more people using the voice part, because you can access it from your phone. You know, you can just hit the little voice option. So it's probably regulated like better to phonetics, you know what I'm saying? Slang and all these type of things. I really feel like Google probably has that down pack under locks for sure.
So Deanne Carson, she wants us to ask our babies before we change their diapers.
Because
it's consent.
It's about consent. So she wants us to ask a baby who has no knowledge of what consent or the fact that it's even in a shitty diaper.
Right.
You know, and just wants us to ask the baby. And she goes,
I guess we should ask the baby, does it want to be birthed too while I'm at it?
What she says is that she doesn't, you know, of course the baby is not literally going to give consent, but she said it's about starting the idea or the, you
like
know,
normalizing.
Yeah, making consent normal from the very beginning. But my problem with that is, okay, so you're asking the baby for consent. The baby cannot give consent.
Right.
Therefore,
you were raping a baby.
Right.
Oh my God. Right. I didn't think
that's
about that.
You raping
rape.
That baby.
I didn't think
diaper.
About that.
That's baby rape. That's exactly
that's
how
terrible.
I was about to go. Like, so, because the baby can't give consent.
Oh.
So, if you want to make consent, like this conversation, like the fact that, you know, and what if you to the point where the baby can give consent? Because babies are in diapers at like
then you got slutty
2
baby.
Years old. and
the baby letting everybody change the diaper.
And babies can say no and yes at that age. Mm-hmm. And like, come here, let me change your diaper. And the baby says no and runs away. So you're supposed to just let your baby run around with a shitty diaper? Or are you supposed to
hold the baby down?
Or just do it anyway.
Coerce the baby.
Then you're teaching the baby that what? That their consent doesn't matter? Because
yeah.
Because you asked the consent and they said no and you did it anyway. Or so you, it's a lose-lose situation for the parent, because either you know, if the kid says no and you do it anyway, you raping the kid.
This is my thing, though. It's a baby. The child, you know, the age of the child is in diapers is usually, you know, from birth to about 3 or 4 years old. Is that, you know, that sound about right, you know?
No, that's too long.
That's too long. Three?
Yeah. Three, yeah, some late.
Oop, okay,
some,
never mind.
some kids are in diapers that long, but that's kind of that's towards the long end.
Okay, yeah. So yeah, I'm saying like up to two, three years in diapers. Mm-hmm. What are they consenting to? What is my child consenting to? This isn't a sexual act. Right. I'm not harming my child. So exactly, I'm taking care of my child. In fact, I'm helping my child. Right. What is my child consenting to? So what are you telling me that I'm teaching my child? You're telling me that I'm teaching my child proper sexual behavior or whatever at 2 years old, at 1 or 2 years old?
I think she's beyond the sex part. It's just that the fact that from birth you own your body and everybody has to ask you permission about your body.
For everything, pretty much, is where she's coming from. Which I kind of can, but it's
on an ideological level.
I can't get past the ridiculousness of it and the impracticality of it and just it's too much soon.
Even as a grown adult, I don't ask anybody to shake their hand. I put my hand out.
Right,
you shake it, you shake it. You don't shake it, well, so, you know, I might give you the finger. But so for a child to be teaching that type of consent for what? If somebody touches my child in a private place, that's wrong, regardless of if my child says yes or not.
Yeah, so that's going to be exactly.
I never thought of that.
I was just going to say, and that brings up the other point, that up to a certain age, you're not even allowed
to
give consent. Like, it doesn't even matter.
Mm-hmm. That's
you
why
know what I mean? So,
consent to what?
Right, to change the diaper. It's consent. Like, but I don't know why a parent needs consent to take care of
their child.
You know what I mean? Like, you're gonna have to ask the kid, can I feed you, baby?
Well,
right?
The other part about that is too, with a parent, and a, or guardian of any sort, there's a, already a trust factor built in with that relationship.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So this child knows they're safe with this person.
Mm-hmm.
And
right.
This, and what you're teaching them is if you're with somebody that you're safe with, you can be vulnerable and mm-hmm. reveal yourself. That's what you're really teaching them in those situations. You know, that's some bullshit. Sorry.
That's some super bullshit.
It is. I'm sorry. I'm not here for that. I tried to rationalize it. And shout out to Maurice. Maurice sent, he tagged me in this even after you put it in the forum, Pip, and he was like, well, I get it, but I, you know, it's not really practical, but I kind of get where she's coming from. Yeah, I get it too, but I'm not here for it. It's not, it's too much too soon. I feel like this is something that she came up with because, like, to get herself out there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Get on TV. Like, make a name for herself. Like, mm-hmm. You know. And she's from, what, Australia or something?
Yeah, this is a slippery slope, but I don't understand. I'm not here for this.
Yeah, I was moving on.
This reminds me of people who listen to their kids, even though their kids don't even know what blue is. This reminds me of that bullshit. This reminds me of that.
Well, I think it also, if people start to take this seriously and
it's a slippery slope, right?
To do this, you're going to have more misbehaved kids because I think part of the reason now my daughter and my wife, they don't have like a bad relationship,
mm-hmm.
but my wife doesn't have the same respect with my daughter that I have.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I told my wife early on, like,
that's because she don't care about what she gets cheese and a pizza
mm-hmm.
and the cheese quiche.
Talking about over there.
Cause she was like, she gonna have the cheese quiche even though the daughter don't see you there.
That's why.
Because my wife would do similar stuff to what this lady's talking mm-hmm. about. She didn't ask cause she changed her diaper, obviously, but as soon as my daughter was able to like form yes and no and things like, she would ask her,
she
like,
listened to her,
she would ask her opinion about what she wanted to wear
mm-hmm.
and what she wanted to eat
mm-hmm. structure
and
discipline
and things like that. And I'm, you know, a little bit more from the old school. And I was like, no, honey, like, you should teach her, you know, to do what you say first.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Discipline first.
Yeah.
She's going to have all the time in the world
uh-huh, to do what she wants.
Do what she want to do.
Mm-hmm.
But she needs to learn that respect
mm-hmm.
and that you're the mama and this and that.
Mm-hmm. And I provide.
Say, and it's not about, you know, this is not a democracy.
Oh, yeah, that's 100%
you know
I mean? True.
Not how, we don't raise kids that way here.
Right.
This is not a democracy here. It's us.
Right.
It's us, and it's what we say.
Right.
Because we know what's best for you.
Exactly.
And that's the way it goes.
Because you guys have her best intentions.
Right. And so that's the way I raised her and dealt with her. And so with me, it's like I say something, and she does it. But with my wife, there's 1,001 questions about why and how come and
excuses and reasons.
And if she feels like she has an option or a choice to do these things because my wife at an early age would ask her about things instead of telling her
mm-hmm.
to do things, you know?
Yeah.
And now it's really hard for her.
Yeah.
Because that's the way she's used to dealing with
mm-hmm.
her. Like everything mommy says is a choice.
Yeah.
Even though now she's trying to backpedal and then say it's not a choice, whatever. It's already in her mind mm-hmm. like that. And that's how things are. So it's like, yeah, that's what you say, but that's not really what you mean.
Right. Exactly.
You know?
And let's talk about it first.
I think that this would lead to more of that.
Oh, definitely. Oh, definitely. I saw a video that's actually been going around about the woman who had her child strapped with the belt. You guys haven't seen this yet?
No.
Oh, my goodness. I should have tagged you guys in this. But it wasn't like an article or anything. It's just like a video that's going around. But it's about a woman. She's in a Walgreens, and the manager of Walgreens is asking her to leave the store because her son is being unruly. Now, she has like a belt around her waist, and it's through the boy's shirt, like through the neck part, going
she
through the bottom.
Kid, she got her kid on a leash.
She got him on the leash, and the belt is on her arm, but the shirt, so the shirt is heisted up like by the boy's neck,
mm-hmm.
and she got him hanging on the belt, and the belt is on her arm like a purse strap,
mm-hmm.
and the shit is all, like in the video, is shit all over the floor. So when by the time they record, the little boy had cleared off a shelf,
mm-hmm.
just cleared off a whole shelf. And so
wow.
the manager is picking up the stuff off the floor,
yeah.
putting the stuff back on the shelves and asking the lady, we've asked you before not to come. You can't come back in here because of your son. You guys do this every time. We've had problems with other managers and you and other managers.
Wow.
And the black lady's like, well, what do you want me to do with my son? I'm not going to hit my child. What do you want me to do? And the little boy, so mind you, the manager's putting all the shit back on the shelf. The little boy cleared the shelf again, right there in front of the mom, and told the man, fuck you. Something. Fuck you. The mother didn't even look the boy's way. She just kept on looking at the man. What do you want me to do? Blah, 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 blah. So the man, she had like a water bottle in her arm and she was trying to make her purchase. So the man took the items out of her hand and said, you have to leave. You cannot be here. So she left.
Wow.
And it was like another little teenage boy in the video. And his eyes, when the little boy said, fuck you. The little boy couldn't even see over the counter.
Wow.
So I feel like this is a slippery slope. Because that was crazy.
Yeah, that's crazy.
A slippery slope from asking people for permission to change their diaper?
Mm-hmm.
That's a long way, Deja.
Mm-hmm. Before you know it, you're going to be just like that lady inside the Walgreens. What do you want me to do? What do you want me to do? He don't want to. I asked him and he said no. I asked him for his consent to behave. And he said no.
Okay, fair point. Right,
exactly. He said no. He said he didn't want this shit on the shelf. So he took it all down. What do you want me to do?
Right. Fair point.
Yep, I hear you. I hear you.
So, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Jacqueline AIDS, 31 of Phoenix, sent... Dejan, you be bragging about your little 14,000 texts a month. She sent 65,000 texts to one dude.
After one day.
After one day. It did take her a year, but still. Yes.
One day.
She was sending up to 500 a day.
I mean, it took her a year, though. That's I do like 14K in a month.
That's past still, thirsty.
That's all your friends and family and everybody. This was just one dude. You know she was texting other people. Who knows how many people she was stalking?
This is I know,
Hitler,
right?
Hitler.
Right?
This is the Lady Hitler,
she had
right?
Hell of a plan. Yes, that's yeah. She
the Lady Hitler.
Mm-hmm. She called herself the new Hitler.
Why?
She likes Hitler.
Oh, she's fucking. She was crazy. I'm crazy.
Oh yeah.
And she stalked the dude.
Yeah, you don't send nobody 65,000 text messages one after date. One date.
And she would say stuff like, "What would I do with your blood? I would swim in it. I'd take a bath in it." Don't ever leave me because I don't want to kill you. Make me a murderer by leaving me. Because if you leave me, I will kill you. After one date.
But.
And then she said, like, I would have never hurt anybody. I just only said that things to him because I thought he was going to leave me.
Right.
Oh, my God. You're crazy.
He finally got arrested.
Finally.
Yeah, finally.
Oh, my God. It takes the police so long to arrest these crazy motherfuckers. I don't get it.
Didn't she get escorted out of his job?
She did.
She showed up at his job?
She showed up at his house. What? He was away on vacation, and she took pictures of herself taking a bath in his bathroom.
Oh, hell nah. Oh, fuck that shit.
It's popping in Phoenix.
Yeah, man.
Oh, hell no. I saw some cigarettes butts outside my window one time. And I was like, fuck that. Who was standing outside my window? And every time I heard a sound, I was jumping up. I couldn't live like this.
No,
I could not.
That's crazy, right?
That's fucking crazy.
That is crazy. That's serious cray-cray.
And then she said she wasn't going to hurt. Oh, Lord. about drink your bath. I wonder what his reaction was. He's on vacation, and then he sees these. She sends him some pictures, and he's like, "That what? Well, wait a minute. That's my. I know that. That's my towel. That's my soap.
Yeah.
Those are my candles. Right? That's my bubble bath."
That's very stalkerific.
Mm-mm. Yeah.
If I saw some shit like that and I was on vacation, when I came home, first of all, I couldn't stay in my house.
Yeah,
until
I'm out.
I got myself some straight up street gang security.
Street gang.
No, I don't want the professionals. I want street gang
security. Yeah, the criminals, right.
I want somebody like that's like nothing to bitch. No. Don't even think about it. Don't look.
Right.
Keep walking.
That part.
Yeah, see.
They ain't got no other job but to be on your ass. What I want.
In my family, I would have been family. There was like, there was a time when my sister, she was living in an apartment. This was before she bought her own place. She lived in an apartment. I lived around the corner in an apartment. And this little thuggy dude moved in with his family, right? His mom and siblings, whatever. And this dude was really feeling my niece, right?
Mm.
So he was being all harassing and stuff or whatever, and was being all disrespectful and stuff. And he was so bold, like he was doing this stuff in front of her boyfriend.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. And Mark was like not having it, right?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Mark was pissed off. So anyway, I think they kind of got into, had some words. They didn't actually, I don't think nothing physical happened, but they got into words and guy made some threats.
Mm.
And so, you know, it you know, it spread throughout the family. Don't think we all came over there. We were sleeping on the floor with our guns. Mm-hmm.